ओम साई राम, माय प्रणाम्स टू बाबा सच्चा साई। रियली आई एम शिवरिंग इवन दो आई एड्रेस्ड सेवरल नेशनल इंटरनेशनल कॉन्फ्रेंसेस कॉन्वोकेशंस एंड बट टॉकिंग फ्रॉम दिस प्लेस I feel little diffident. Anyhow, with the blessings of Baba, I think I can tell whatever I can. Pranams to all the great people assembled here. Bhishma Pitamaha, Justice Venkatachalaya, Honorable Justice Bhandari International Court Judge, Justice Amitav Rai, Justice Mukhopadhyaya, Chief Justice of Andhra Pradesh, Justice Radhakrishna, Sai devotees, brothers and sisters, my pranams to everybody. See, in everybody, everyone's life, miracles will happen. But there are three important miracles happened. All are related to Bhagwan Satya Sai. Even though 1973, I was very young, studying 10th class. One day, somebody took me in Bombay to see Satya Sai. I was too young. I don't know anything about Baba. They said that you follow the principles of Baba. Thereafter, there is a long gap. Only after marrying in 1986, again, my connections are strengthened and my wife, Baba was blessed me. The first miracle what happened is, I married a family of Baba devotees long. My wife was named by Baba as Sivamala. And thereafter, I started coming frequently. This is the first miracle happened. Why I am saying it's a miracle is, even though I enrolled as advocate and I used to work hard, I never used to get the results properly. Results in the sense, nobody recognized my hard working. I used to work 18 hours a day. After marriage and I am starting coming, one day, Baba asked me, first time I came and I sat there in third row. He came there and he asked me, Bangaru, get up. I stand up. What you want? I said, Swami, nothing. I don't know. Swami, nothing. You don't want nothing. He laughed. Okay. He blessed me with vibhuti. I went back. And thereafter I start realizing that whatever hard work I done, I started that the fruits are coming. That is the first miracle. Thereafter, one day I brought my two young daughters with me. I never expected that Baba will give an interview or call me. Suddenly he asked us to come to the room. And I asked my two young daughters, what you want to be? My elder one said that I want to be a doctor. He said that, okay, you are going to be a doctor. The other one is a small, what you want? She doesn't know, she laughed, you will be a lawyer. Now, with the grace of Baba, my daughter, elder daughter is a radiologist working in Delhi. Second one is working as a lawyer practicing in Delhi and Andhra Pradesh. This is the second miracle. Third miracle is, when I came, he said that, he asked me, I am sitting in the corridor, Baba asked me to rise. Don't worry, Bangaru, the difficulties, whatever everybody faces, is a passing clouds. I did not understand what it means. And I never told to anybody that I had any difficulties, and I never felt that I had any difficulties. But later on I realized, after going back home, my recommendations, which is pending from the last 1.5 years, at that point of time as a judge, by the time I reached back, Chief Justice of India called me to come and meet him. And he told me that we cleared your name for elevation of High Court judge yesterday. After elevation as judge, twice I came, Baba never given any interview, I never expected also. But thereafter, third time, again invited, asked me to come to his room and said that, "Bangaru, I told you long back that I want to give you some protection. I told Swami, you are already protecting me. What more protection I need? You need a protection." Then he has given this ring. I told Swami, I normally don't wear any gold ornaments or any ornaments at all. "No, Bangaru, here afterwards you have to wear this. See, it is a protection for you. You are working in a public office, you need protection." This is how Swami has taken care. I have not done anything, any contribution to the initiation or Swami, but this is the love and affection Swami has shown on our family. I am indebted to Swami a lot. Coming back to the issue, because today I was assigned a job, I never expected that I will stand before you and give a talk. It is another miracle. Normally I used to sit somewhere and hear all the people who are giving some speeches, and particularly Swami's speech. But today Swami, it seems, ordered me to talk something on the legal system, which I am working. So taking the order, I am going to deliver some of the important issues. I know that you are already tired of hearing all of us, but it is my duty to tell something about the Baba's institutions and the legal system. I feel blessed to remember the teachings of Baba based on 5 most important human values: Satya, Dharma, Shanti, Prema, and Ahimsa. When truth is the eventual icon of theology, human is divine. The judicial and legal systems that are functioning to search for Satya, therefore, are under mandate of Dharma to protect the truth and truth alone. I understand from the preachings of Baba that truth is the human value, and the institution of judiciary is meant to enhance this value. Baba emphatically reiterated number of times that there is only one religion, that is religion of love. There is only one caste, the caste of humanity. There is only one language, the language of heart. And there is only one God, that is omnipresent. Baba's belief in service to humanity is renowned from grassroots to international level. It's Baba's presence that put a small, remote, tiny village of Puttaparthi on the global map, with best of educational institutions, multi-specialty hospitals, world-class drinking water and other facilities and other amenities. More than the infrastructure, it is the infinite compassion and love which is visible here. Everyone in our day-to-day life encounters several challenges and circumstances which test our patience, peace of mind, and character. Values we believe influence the way we react to a situation, and they are the guiding principles of life. Values are formed by interaction of a man with his family, friends, society, education system, and environment. Education and values are inseparable and two sides of a coin. Education should promote a sense of morality and intellectualism among the students. They should be taught moral social responsibility to care for their fellow beings and follow dharma. In the context of acquiring education, we need to concentrate on how to provide value to next generation. We must not only provide these values from early age to our children, but also we must adapt them ourselves. We have been seeing a steady rise in case of molestation, intolerance, etc. every day, which is nothing but a result of degradation of values. As citizens, we do not speak up for values and precautions. We cannot protect anyone from such heinous crimes. We cannot sit quietly in a corner and think that no antisocial element or a bad neighborhood affect us. Man, being a social animal, cannot isolate himself from society. In this context, I appropriately modified the poem of German Lutheran pastor Martin, which was created against Nazis' invasion. I quote, "First they came for the weak, and I did not speak out, because I did not care for the monastery. Then they came for the neighborhood, and I did not speak out, because I was not in the vicinity. Then they came for the friends, and I did not speak out, because I was not one of them. Then they came for me, and there is no one left to speak for me," unquote. The moral is that we must discuss, share, express, and try to settle the problems at community level before they blow up and cause big problems. I feel that the human values are the first line of weapon as well as defense, so that we can have good citizens, good neighborhoods, and ultimately good country. This is what Baba means when he observed, I quote, "If there is righteousness in the heart, there will be beauty in character. If there is beauty in character, there will be harmony in the home. When there is harmony in the home, there will be order in the nation. Where there is an order in the nation, there will be peace in the world," unquote. I take this opportunity to highlight Baba's creation in the field of education, which is remarkable and outstanding. His Holiness innovative of Bala Vikas in 1968 was to realize the divine truth, which resides in every human being, and to bring out the good conduct, sense of universal brotherhood from early age. Modern education system are running a mad race while forgetting the essential requirement of meditation, prayer, stories of great men and women of all religions and beliefs. Baba always used to say, the end of education is character, and the end of knowledge is love. It is with this profound belief that the Baba has created institutions of education, formal as well as community, to uphold, cherish his wisdom. Now, coming to legal aspects of human values, Aristotle once said, I quote, "Man is the best of all animals when he has reached his full development. So he is worst of all when divorced from law and morals," unquote. Our systems are based on the two pillars of law and morality. When we talk about morality, we come to the realm of human values. These two aspects are explicitly recognized by our Constitution in the preambular aspirations as well as various articles under the Constitution. In Shanti Parva of Mahabharata, Yudhishthira states that a state can only be preserved by dharma, which is the centennial of a human value. In my considered opinion, what we refer as rule of law is nothing but dharma. There is no dispute that Indian judiciary is the foremost protecting in this rule of law. The endeavor of every law officer is to uphold rule of law or dharma. I may give many instances where the Indian judiciary in its judgments uphold the values of human values and interpreted constitution. When 13 judges of the Supreme Court sat to hear Kesavananda Bharati case, they had to make a choice either to uphold the values we gave ourselves during framing of the constitution or to accept the malignant change being introduced. Supreme Court in its Manmouth judgment clearly identified the values and stability of the country. In Chameli Singh case, the Supreme Court said that right to food is a part of fundamental right. In Mohini Jain case, education was declared as a fundamental right. In M.C. Mehta case, it was observed to develop full potential of children, they should be prohibited from doing hazardous work and education must be made available to them. There are n number of judgments which the Supreme Court has supported the human values. And next issue is the legal systems and societies cannot be built or sustained by reference only to strict text of law alone. It requires judges as artists to imbibe humanism into the law as well. Rather, a balance must be struck, rules, principles, precepts, norms and values. Law is not just command. It is a will of the society, amenable to rational general expression, producing loyalty and consent through its utility, particularly through its characteristics of certainty, fairness and justice. All you know that the courts are flooded with family disputes, commercial disputes and cases arising out of crimes. My Lord Justice Venkatachalaya already given narrated the figures also about the pending cases. We can look at the root cause of all these types of disputes. We find that lack of human values is the root cause. The absence of prema is the root cause of family disputes. The disturbance in shanti and failure to understand ahimsa parama dharma is the root cause of for the criminal disputes. Failure to adhere to the dharmic principles is the root cause for commercial disputes. Disputes of all type arise when selfishness overtakes the bondage of love. Once we identify the root cause, then a judge can easily adjudicate the matter. To put it simply, it is possible for a judge to be mere neutral umpire and declare that results as a mechanic such as a computer. But what is expected of a judge is something more. We have to fine-tune the people to adhere to the values of love, ultimately to cause the cause of dispute gets narrowed down. Recently, Fali Narimon, eminent jurist, in his book, God Save the Supreme Court, has observed that, I will quote it, the judge's role when interpreting the Constitution is like that of an artist drawing a picture. The frame of the picture and the artistic tools must always be drawn from the text of the Constitution, its structure and the country's history, but there must also be some measure of the artist's own vision and understanding, unquote. Supreme Court in number of decisions has upheld the human values. I would like to highlight Article 142 of the Constitution of India, which is unique as it confers unlimited power to the Supreme Court to do complete justice. This power is ultimately, that power is utilized not only big constitutional issues, but also in other matters to uphold basic human values. The motto that is attached to, on the Supreme Court emblem says, Etho Dharma Sato Jaya, means where there is dharma, there is victory. Various high courts have the emblem observing Satyame Jayati, which means truth always triumphs. Supreme Court can wield power to uphold dharma and not only to uphold truth or justice, sixth sense. Last but not least, we are fortunate to be among us one of the India's greatest contributor of justice to human values, Justice M.N. Venkatachalaya. He has been the torchbearer of human values and human rights among legal fraternity. Justice Venkatachalaya, former Chief Justice of India, once said, I quote, next to the study of religion and philosophy, if there is anything worth studying, it is law, unquote. Nothing strengthens the intellect of a seeker of knowledge more than the learning of law. It is befitting herein that such a great man is being felicitated. And I hope and expect that the human values will be accepted, respected, and give a position they deserve for the upliftment of the society. I conclude by quoting the words of Baba. I quote, Whoever tries to understand the human values of truth, righteousness, conduct, peace, love, and non-violence properly, who practices these values and propagates them with zeal and sincerity, can alone be described as truly educated persons, unquote. I must thank the organizers, Ms. Nimesh Pandey and Mrs. Seema, for allowing me and to interact or to deliver this lecture. Satyame Jayati. Before that, oka Telugu vadiga Satya Sai ki priyamainatuvanti moodu vishayalu unnai. Okati Matru Devata, rendodi Matru Bhumi, moododi Matru Bhasha. Andukane తల్లి ఈశ్వరమ్మ గారి పేరుతో సంస్థలు స్థాపించిన తన పుట్టినటువంటి పుట్టపర్తి అభివృద్ధి కోసం ప్రపంచంలో గుర్తింపు తెచ్చినటువంటి కోసం పనిచేసినటువంటి బాబా తనకు ప్రియతమైనటువంటి తెలుగు భాషలోనే మాట్లాడేవాళ్ళు. అందుకని చెప్పేసి మిత్రులారా, మీ మనకు తెలుగు వాళ్ళు, ప్రత్యేకించి తెలుగు వాళ్ళందరూ కూడా ఎంతో గర్వించి ఆనందించినటువంటి విషయం ఏంటంటే సత్యసాయి ఈ నేలలో పుట్టడం. ఈ అవకాశం ఇచ్చినటువంటి అందరికీ కృతజ్ఞతలు తెలియజేస్తున్నాను.